You see it in the news all the time, right? The dollar strengthens, or the local currency is taking a nosedive. And you probably wonder, what does that even mean for me, for the country? It sounds super complicated, but it really all boils down to one big question. Is it better for an economy to have a strong currency or a weak one? So let's get into it and figure this out. Here's how we're going to break it down. First, we'll get the basics straight, what an exchange rate actually is. Then we'll look at what happens when a currency weakens. That's called devaluation. And when it strengthens, appreciation. After that, we'll tackle the big debate, which is better? And finally, we'll see who's pulling the levers behind the scenes, the central bank. All right, let's start at square one. What in the world is an exchange rate? Honestly, you can just think of it as a price tag. It's simply the price of one country's money, but paid for it with another country's money.
So for our example, let's say the exchange rate is 3.65 Israeli shekels to the US dollar. All that means is that you need 3.65 shekels to buy just one US dollar. That number, 3.65, that's it. That's the exchange rate. It's the price of a dollar in shekels. Let's keep that number in our heads as we go.
Okay, so let's dive into our first big concept, devaluation. This is what we're talking about when we say the local currency, in this case the shekel, is getting weaker.
So remember our starting point, right? One US dollar costs 3.65 shekels. Simple enough. Now, let's imagine the shekel devalues, or weakens, by 10%.
The math here is pretty straightforward. You just take our base rate of 3.65 and tack on that 10%. The new rate? It's about 4.02. Now, here's the key thing to notice, and it's a little counterintuitive. For the currency to get weaker, the number actually goes up.
So, what's the bottom line? The shekel is now officially weaker. You need more of them, over 4 shekels now, just to buy that same single US dollar. From the shekel's perspective, the dollar just got more expensive, which means the dollar got stronger.
All right, let's flip that on its head and look at the exact opposite, appreciation. This is the fancy word for when the local currency gets stronger.
Okay, back to our familiar starting line. 3.65 shekels gets you $1. But this time, instead of weakening, let's say the shekel appreciates, or gets stronger, by 5%.
As you'd expect, the calculation is just the reverse of what we did before. A 5% appreciation means we multiply by 0.95. Our new exchange rate is now down to about 3.47. And again, notice the pattern. For the currency to get stronger, the exchange rate number actually goes down.
And that's really all there is to appreciation. The shekel is stronger. It's got more muscle, you could say. Because now you need fewer shekels to buy that exact same US dollar. Relative to the shekel, the dollar just got a little weaker.
So we've got these two opposite forces, right? Devaluation, making a currency weaker, and appreciation, making it stronger. And that brings us to the million-dollar question. Which one is actually better for a country's economy?
Okay, so let's just quickly recap to make sure we're on the same page. Devaluation means weaker currency. Appreciation means stronger currency. Now let's see how this choice plays out in the real world.
So check this out. When a currency gets weaker, it kicks off a whole chain reaction. If you're an exporter selling things in dollars, every dollar you earn is suddenly worth more shekels. Ka-ching, your profits go up. But at the same time, all the stuff we import from other countries gets more expensive. That makes people more likely to buy locally made goods, which is great for domestic companies.
So what's the big picture here? Well, if your main goal is creating jobs, a weaker currency can look really attractive. When exporters and local businesses are doing well, they're much more likely to hire people. That means more jobs and lower unemployment. But, and this is a huge but, there's a major catch. It's called inflation. When imports get more expensive, the cost of living goes up for everyone. Your phone, your car, even your coffee. It all costs more.
Now, these currency swings don't just happen by accident.
Oh no,
this is an area where government policy has a massive, massive impact, and the institution right in the thick of it is the central bank.
The central bank is basically the manager of the country's currency, and it can and often does take active steps to cause a devaluation, to intentionally weaken the currency, all in an effort to help local industries and boost employment. But it's a constant balancing act, weighing that goal against the very real danger of causing prices to spiral upwards.
Which brings us to our final critical question. If a weaker currency is so good for jobs, why not just do it all the time? Why not keep pushing it weaker and weaker? Well, the catch, as we just saw, is inflation. If everything you buy from abroad gets more and more expensive, you can really hurt consumers and even destabilize the whole economy. Finding that perfect sweet spot between more jobs and stable prices, well, that's one of the toughest challenges in all of economics. Something to think about.